In this video, we are going to see the processing of the ceramics matrix composites. So the first two process making here reinforcement precursors of matrix with the reinforcement. Here we are three methods are there. Three methods are known as powder deposition, liquid precursors, and gaseous infiltration. So to put a rigidized or densified matrix in a place, the precursors of the matrix has to be positioned with the mass of the reinforcement. So these three methods are for making the precursors matrix has to be positioned with the mass of the reinforcement. First of all, I will thank Bosha KIDAPSME Helmets for this slide for his slides. Next is powder depression impregnates the reinforcement with a suspension of matrix precursors in a powder form, either by passing the reinforcement through a slurry or by pressure impregnation of a perform or by electrophoretic infiltration. The powder depression method is the most widely used where a simple approach using the substance of known composition or characterize is required. Most types of the matrix can positioned using this method. Normally, it requires that the fibers or viscous architecture is opened up so that powder's particles can completely surround each reinforcing element, and that there is a sufficient powder entering for the densified matrix to fill the space around the reinforcement to an adequate degree, usually completely. Matrix precursors entrained in this way, even if sinter active, tend to be reluctant to sinter to full density because of the restraint posed by the non-sintering reinforcement structure, and hot pressing, usually uniaxial, is required to close voids between the reinforcement elements. This process does not readily lend itself to complex shapes. Generally, plate shapes with planar reinforcements are easiest to produce because the reinforcement is not greatly distorted, and thus it is not a particularly versatile for producing the components for the complex architecture. Next, liquid precursors impregnates the reinforcement performed with a liquid organic or organometallic or inorganic substance, typically a polymer or salt, with which on heating the residues by curing or gelling, and then decomposes to leave a ceramic matrix. A more reliable way of penetrating the reinforcement architecture is to use a liquid precursor. This can be in the form of an aqueous solvent, example biomite, ALOOH, later to form alumina, or an organic or organometallic metallic polymer which decomposes on heating to form a ceramic. Thus, the disadvantage of this method is it is not very efficient method because of the volume occupied by the resulting solid, which must much less than that of the impregnated liquid. Several stages of repeated impregnation and decomposition may be needed to obtain an impregnated final product, which even so still contains the inter-reinforcement reinforcement closed porosity. The advantage of this method is that the complex shapes can be made based on the reinforcement performance, but the disadvantage is the cost in terms of the number of processing steps involved. Next studies in the liquid based routes, the fibers first coated with the interface are embedded in the liquid precursors of the matrix. In the reactive melt infiltration process, a fiber perform is impregnated by capillary forces with a liquid which reacts either with a solid paste used to consolidate the fiber perform Example, silicon carbide to silicon matrix formed through a liquid silicon infiltration of the carbon solid consolidated to form or with the atmosphere. Among the other advantages, the reactive melt infiltration process are fast and can be applied to the thick forms. They also yield materials of low residual porosities and high thermal conductivity. In the polymer impregnation and pyrolysis, process, the fibers are embedded in a polymeric precursors of the matrix, such a thermosetting resin or a pitch for carbon or a polycarboxylene for silicon carbide, and the green composite in is then pyrolyzed. Such a process are relatively flexible since composition of the precursors can be tailored. Then the gaseous infiltration process, using a reactive gases mixture which deposits a ceramic material within a form of the reinforcement, commonly known as the chemical vapor deposition or chemical vapor infiltration, and typically performed at a high temperature, all of which have particularly advantages and disadvantages of different types of matrix materials. For those matrix materials which can be produced by reaction between the gases such as carbon and silicon carbide, a gas process route can be substituted for the liquid impregnation route. Then this tends to be a slow process, because if deposition is allowed to occur too quickly, it mostly occurs at the external surface, blocking penetration. Developments in the technique have concentrated on ensuring that a deposition occurs internally to the component by forcing reactive gas flow through the walls of the components. Using temperature gradient and speeding the process up, example by using microwave heating, which also has the advantage of improving deposition internally to the form. However, as with liquid infiltration, full densification of the matrix never occurs, as access to remaining the porous become blocked. But the method can be used for complex shapes. In gas phase routes, so-called chemical vapor infiltration process, the reinforcement is densified by the matrix deposited for form a gaseous precursor. Example, an hydrocarbon or for carbon or a mixture of methyltrichloroxylene and hydrogen for silicon carbide. There are several versions of the CVA process. Is there now well established that fiber coating referred to as the interface has to be deposited on the fiber prior to the infiltration on the matrix to the matrix, in order to control the fiber matrix bonding and the mechanical behavior of the composites. Next, we are going to see the hot pressing process. Here it is the uniaxial and two-dimensional fiber composites with the glass matrix can be produced by hot pressing process. Then the fibers are immersed in a slurry of matrix particles and then dried. After that, the fiber matrix powder form is then cut into suitable dimensions and stacked in a hot pressing in order to produce the dense composites. The fabricated composites are usually in the shape of flat or rectangular plates. Densification of viscous composite usually performed by hot pressing. Careful control is required both to avoid damage to the viscous and to achieve the homogeneous dispersion of viscous. Here you can see this is the hot pressing process. Okay, the right side diagram explaining the hot pressing process. Here the powder. Powder and the combination is filled, then then the lower punch will be there, then the upper punch will be there. Once the entire fiber mat composition filled, then it will be pressed with some amount of load will be applied both upper die and the lower die. So after that process will be there, then the upper portion will be ejected, then the down lower punch will be moved upward direction. Due to this, what will happen, the component will be taken outside. This is the hot pressing process. Then next we are going to see the hot isostatic pressing. Here you can see this, the pressure will be applied either all the direction. Due to this, what will happen, it will be inside the steel container. Due to the what will happen, the pressure part, okay, the pressure part will be converted as a required composite part. Then the chemical vapor impregnation is the method of infiltrating fiber architecture with the matrix particles via vapor paste. Although this is the similar process to chemical vapor deposition in terms of the gas reaction and the decomposition of conditions of CV are chosen for in depth of decomposition rather than coating the surface of the substrate, several techniques have been developed to introduce the reaction gases into the fiber architecture, such as temperature gradient, pressure gradient and pulse CVI. Here you can see this is the chemical vapor impregnation process. This is the hot surface, this is the cold surface, fibrous perform, then infiltrated composite will be there. Okay, CVI equipment for the temperature gradient technique. Pre-ceramic polymer can fill a perform with a liquid polymer, either molten or in the solution form, which are then pyrolyzed to make the ceramic matrix. Polymer impregnation and thermal decomposition are repeated several times. Resins such as phenol and pitch are used for producing carbon matrix composite or organosilicon compounds such as a polycarbosaline and polyvinyl saline are used to impregnation of silicon carbide. Salts have also been used for infiltering perform to produce oxide matrix such as alumina, silica, zirconia and mullite. Following infiltration, they are gelled by drying or by adjusting the temperature, and the matrix is formed after treatment. Here you can see this liquid infiltration process is explaining. This is the liquid infiltration process. Here hot coil will be there, heating coil will be there, then this is the perform. Then the piston will be upward direction, will be given in the upward portion. Okay, it is similar to resin transfer molding process, which is used for the processing there of polymer matrix composite. There are three major issues to be considered in the liquid infiltration process. One is chemical reactivity, then metal viscosity and wettability. In chemical reactivity, the process is done at elevated temperature. At high temperature, the reinforcement and the matrix may react, resulting in the unnecessary reaction, which deteriorates the bonding between the reinforcement base and the matrix base. In the metal viscosity, the melt viscosity of the ceramics is high compared to that of the metal, which can result in the inability of the ceramics infiltrant to infiltrate into the fibrous ceramic perform. In wettability of the reinforcement, the infiltrant may not be able to wet the reinforcement, resulting in improper bonding, which further leads to the failure of the product at the interface of reinforcement and matrix. Then the advantage is matrix homogeneous structure can be processed. The matrix can be performed in a single processing step. Fiber perform in uniform. Disadvantage is this complicated task, as the ceramic have higher melt viscosities than metals. Difference in case between the matrix and fiber reinforcing case, due to the crack will be developed. Then melting points of ceramic results in the greater possibilities of reaction between the liquid matrix and the reinforcement. So thank you very much for watching this video.